Do some backlight to get my hair out of the shadows.
What backlight? Were you going to throw something behind
like
there?
I just look like a small, little floating head with no hair.
Floating head, no...
No,
what's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing something a little different. I am joined with Kian, Lawley.
Kian, Lawley. Mukbang!
And Bobby, I don't think I've ever done one on my channel.
I'll do a gum mukbang.
We're here. My Instagram story thing was fucking funny, but weird.
Well, that.
It tripped me out, yeah.
I watched it twice.
Basically, we're gonna do like something kind of like a little podcast. I didn't have all the gear because I'm doing a broke one because I don't want to invest all my money in getting it. Because I want to like try this out. To see if I want to do more of them or not. So it's kind of like a trial period. So I don't want to buy like $1,000 of gear just to, you know, not do it ever again.
I'll use this.
That's a microphone. This is my microphone.
This is mine.
Hello.
Hello, hello.
Testing, I met my finger.
I love how you went through testing. You're like, and then you're like, I bit my finger. You're like your third one down.
What are your plans in the future? I don't know yet.
Next one? That's a good question. Okay. I don't know.
So basically, we're going to go off from the top, and you already know what the first question is, apparently, but what is your future plans?
I don't know.
What do you guys have, like, planned?
I'm going to get a tattoo.
I'll probably get a tattoo, film a couple videos. That's it.
No, I'm going to finish this bagel bite. That's my plan right now.
You guys are the worst to have on my channel. You guys give me no answers. Well, future plans, like,
you know, it's hard to plan things. Just a second ago, I was playing cards on the deck, and now I'm on the Titanic with you fine folk. What's that from?
Titanic.
Jack Dawson. What was the question?
Like in future, like future plans, Dawson. Like maybe like a couple, like Elliot 2 years Dawson. Time. 2 years no. Time. All right, you get 2 years time. Like where do you see yourself?
Seashells.
Seashells by the seashore.
I know where I see myself in the future. In a mirror.
You're literally the worst in this.
I see myself as a still working and thriving actor. That's funny.
I think you said thriving.
Thriving,
not because
yeah.
Of what you said.
Oh, not thriving actor. What is it, like a...
up and coming?
No, I don't want to be up and coming still in 2 years. I want to be an established actor, but still like...
Humble?
Work hard. Like, I still want to work really hard. I still don't want... Like, I never want to be at a point in my life where I'm too comfortable.
Yeah.
I want to continue to, like, work hard.
Yeah.
Hopefully
same
in a movie.
For me.
Hopefully yeah. In a movie with Jim Carrey. What do you want to do? You want to be, like, director, producer?
YouTuber?
Yeah,
I'm gonna be a big YouTuber in 2 years. What's so freaking funny? I am. Just wait!
You're already a big YouTuber.
No, I'm not, Corey.
What do you have? What are you at?
Huh?
What are you at?
Almost at 700,000.
What's Franny at?
Probably 2 or something.
No, she's like 4.
Dude, I have no clue.
I don't either. What are you at?
I've been stuck at 296 like 3 months now. Subscribers.
Can I help her out? I know. Subscribe. I know it's not. Everyone subscribe to me.
As the guy sitting on the bottom, help me out, please.
Yeah.
Everyone, let's get.
So you want to be.
Corey to 300K.
7,000 away from 300K. So you want to see it?
7K away?
Yeah. I've been sitting at this for a while, but I haven't been posting in a while. So, hey, welcome back, Corey. So you want to be a big YouTuber in 2 years?
Yeah.
That's like your plan. It's like,
my name and likes.
On the YouTube homepage.
On the YouTube homepage. Dude, I'm going to be on the YouTube homepage in 2 years.
That's your plan?
Yeah, why not? Fine, 1 year.
Okay, let's move on to the next one.
What's your plan?
My plan? To have done one movie. If I haven't done that, I probably will just give up and go home and never work again.
And be married. He's gonna be married.
I don't wanna be married in 2 years.
Why?
I'll be married when I'm like 28.
That's in 2 years.
That's in like 4 years.
No.
5.
We're the same age!
Yeah, 5 years.
Barely! It's like 3 months.
Yeah, we're all the same age.
Favorite video that you guys have ever made? What's your favorite video that you've ever made? Like, ever done?
Like on my channel?
Yeah.
One of my favorites is when we scared everyone with that clown mask.
Oh, with Franny.
Freaking funny. Yeah, that was like a good
one.
Because, yeah. I feel really bad messing with people.
Oh.
We like try to get Freddy's back.
But we watched a scary movie before that.
It was after It. And I don't know, it was very fun. I don't know if you were there. Sorry, Kian.
Oh, he was doing Atlanta, I think.
Probably. I don't really know my favorite. I feel like all
you
of my
have like
I have
8 years of like what's
I
your favorite?
I have so many videos. Dude, yeah, I really don't know.
What's like one of your like that you can just not your favorite but like a favorite? Mine probably wasn't my favorite, but
the one that's popping up is JC and I. We did the slippery yoga challenge where we put baby oil all over ourselves.
That one was funny.
That was funny. I laughed a lot.
I was filming that one and just seeing like JC flying through the air.
Oh no, not that one.
The one in front of the house?
Yeah.
The one in front of the house is. I love that.
That was funny.
I forgot that one.
I remember you were doing something on top of him and you just like.
My knee. Kneed him in the back.
It's his face with it all too. Because you like hurt him and then he just like takes it. It's funny.
My favorite one so far right now, because of the experience and the story behind it.
I know what you're going to
say. Which one?
The Greatest Showman.
No, it's not. My greatest one is actually when we had the whole trauma with New Year's trying to stay somewhere and we drove all the way up to, Big Sur. And there was nowhere they could have us and we broke the light. We had to get batteries.
It was bad. We're in the middle of like the mountains with no light.
That was a funny
gas. There was nothing.
It was just a bunch of luck and like catastrophic things happening. And then I had to be at Starbucks. We drove 4 hours to go to Starbucks so I can upload the last Vlogmas. I'm gonna leave that video in the description if you want to watch that. But that's my favorite video I've ever had.
That's a very good one.
That's a good one, yeah.
Like the story times, oh my god. And we like cooked hot dogs. It was like the best thing.
Those are the best hot dogs. Best food in the world is cooked on a cooker.
Who's your dream collab? Like, if you have one YouTuber that you want to like dream collab with.
You and David Dobrik. I would love to watch that.
I've been with David Dobrik.
Oh, looks like it's done for me then. No, me and, does it have to be a YouTuber?
It could be.
It has to be, yeah.
Has to be a YouTuber?
Say Jim Carrey.
Me, I don't really collab with people. Me and JC collab.
Look at that arm looks big.
I really don't.
This arm does not look big. Because the warp.
Okay, I'll put that in. Bobby's warp, guys.
Warp tour.
Warp tour, come see me.
You don't have a dream, do you have a dream person that you want to collab with on YouTube?
I don't.
Mine's Shane Dawson. I'd love to collab with Shane Dawson.
That's a good one. I don't know. I'm just gonna say Casey Neistat.
Casey Neistat.
But I don't know what we would do. Like, I don't know an actual thing. But I think it's cool.
Well, your dream person, yeah.
Dream person, I did it already with Steve-O. We did it.
Is he a YouTuber?
He's not a YouTuber.
Well, yeah, he is. He has probably more videos than
you. That's also one of my questions. So you guys met Jim Carrey.
Jeffries?
Yes.
How did Jim Carrey?
I met him first.
How did Jim Carrey become your?
No, you did not.
Yes.
Oh, he did not.
Yeah, he looked at me first.
No, he did not.
Yeah, he did.
Did you guys still review about this?
Review the footage. Is this toothpaste?
Something.
Why isn't that going in?
It's thick.
Is it Lubriderm?
Yeah, it's the extra dry skin one.
All right.
How did your So you guys met Jim Carrey. How did he become your idol? Just like through movies?
He's not my idol. He's just someone I like.
He's not your idol? He's your idol then.
100%.
I don't have any idols.
1000%. He's my idol.
How did he become your idol? Just growing up, was your favorite actor?
For some reason, I think it just like clicked. Like I was watching it and it's just like, for some reason, I was just like, that's the funniest thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
Well, yeah,
and then
first,
I want to mimic it.
At first, it's like funny. You get to see his humor and like he's a good actor and he has range and he can do this, he can do that. He's almost invincible. He can't do anything else. And then he comes out and he's an artist. You're like, okay, now he can't do anything else. And then he comes out and he's like an activist and he talks
about. So you only liked him at the end, knowing of everything he can do?
No, I loved him and then he just kept adding more and more and more and that just like grew my love.
Yeah, he's
him.
A smart
Is that
guy.
What you painted
he's a
now?
Very smart guy.
No, I painted all my life. Well, I've drawn on my life. Painting, I've kind of taken up recently.
Do you think it was subconscious because of Jim?
No.
Because he's your idol?
No. Like, I used to take painting classes back when I was, like, 15.
What grade?
I was 15.
No, what grade did you get in the class?
I don't know. No, Jim Carrey, yeah. It was kind of like you said, it was just, like, it's just kind of just, like, grew on me. It wasn't, like, one day where I was like, nah, he's not. Yeah, he is, actually. It was just kind of like a growing thing. I just grew up with him. Can someone kiss me?
I'm getting a little weird.
You go for it.
No, it's a PG podcast. PG. Okay. It's a PG broke podcast.
Rated R is 17 and above. PG-13 is 13 and above. What is PG? What age is that?
Parental guidance.
Yeah. Okay, so parental guidance 13. What does that mean?
That's like you need parents there, and you need to be 13.
No, that means if you're 13, you're good to go. If you're 12, you have to have parental guidance.
Then why is it PG still? Why is it just called 13?
Because for like soccer, it says 17 and under.
What's MA?
You could be 17.
Do you guys have MA here?
Mature audience.
MMA.
Yeah, it's 15 plus, right?
I think 17.
17 is rated R, but both. Let's just go to the next question.
Yo, what's the next question?
Okay. My next question is, so you released music in the past.
I have.
And you've been singing a lot more on your Instagram stories.
Is this an interview or is it a podcast?
Podcast, I'm just wondering. Do you guys have any like future musical plans?
No, it's not.
I have a new chorus that I made. Yeah. So, ow, you made me rip my new tattoo off.
So why
you got
it,
stuck in this?
Why
did
it
roll?
The same thing.
Why did it call it the same thing?
Podcast and an interview. Why isn't
it's the same thing?
It's not.
Yes, it is.
Different names.
Well, then this would be more of an interview than a podcast, because podcast would be distribution to other platforms.
Okay, so why did Corey say this is a podcast?
Because it's podcast-like in terms of the realm of existence.
Let's go by that.
Okay, well, yeah, this is.
Why are you hassling me?
This is podcast-like, but he said we're doing a podcast. He didn't say we're doing something like a podcast. He said we're doing a podcast, but this isn't a podcast.
Why does it matter?
Because
why does it matter?
I thought we were doing a podcast.
Don't even talk to him. I got you.
If this is an interview, I want to walk the F out.
Why?
Because he said we're doing a podcast.
So you'd rather do a podcast than an interview?
Yeah.
Well, then welcome to the podcast. It will. He's going to distribute this elsewhere.
Yeah, it's going to be on Spotify.
Do I talk weird sometimes? Are you about to cry? Why are your eyes watering?
You can do a video podcast.
Yeah, you can. We're doing it right now.
That's
you can't
interview.
See my hair, but
no, it looks like that. It's not an interview.
Yeah? You haven't answered any of the questions. You're just
I have answered the questions.
Okay, what are you putting out music, Corey?
I'm thinking about doing a rap.
He's been talking about that for years.
Yeah.
Truly.
Because every YouTuber can do it. So
can I answer the question, please?
Sure.
I'd love to put out music. I just can't.
Yeah, I have a chorus that I made. So it's moving pretty quick. Check it out soon.
What, are you going to release it soon or no?
Yeah, I'm going to release a chorus soon. I'm rebranding music. I'm only doing choruses.
It's the only,
the only thing people like is a chorus. They're waiting for the chorus. Just put out choruses. Why are you crying again?
Is it catchy?
Why are you crying? Yeah, I don't want to hear verses just to get to the chorus. I want to do a song with 8 choruses.
Sometimes the verses are the best part.
Wait, no. Name one.
Yes,
Katy Perry Firework, Plastic Bag. Get to the firework part. It's all about the choruses. Rebranding music. No one's done it.
Yeah?
Who? Who put out choruses? Ariel. The Ariel effect.
This is when it becomes like part of the video where Kian gets bored, so he just starts mucking around and it just gets like downhill.
Stop mucking around, you mucker.
Yeah, we get it. So Kian just pretty much just said the most idiotic thing. He literally just said. Basically, he just said that tattoos are dumb, but he has it all over him. So
yeah,
I just
and
don't
he
know
said
why
he hates YouTubers,
yeah.
YouTube audiences. That's what he said.
He says he hates
did
his
you?
Fans. He hates his fans. Wow. Did you hear that?
I just hear. I was bagel bites and they're good.
Put a slap effect. That was like this.
That's too much in editing.
No,
that's too much.
I filmed a video the other day talking about me releasing the song I wrote. If you guys didn't know, I wrote a song.
You put out a video about that?
Yeah, I wrote a song and I told you guys I was gonna put it out in like May. Never did. It's August. It's September now. And yeah, hopefully by the end of the year I'm gonna squeeze one out, rather than Sisters of Christ.
Like you're gonna go into a studio and record it?
No. Okay, I'm just gonna film it on my camera with a mic and a guitar.
Wow,
super low key acoustic version.
That's low key.
And do you know what takes this kid like at least I think like 35 Instagram stories just to post one singing clip?
Well yeah, mother freaker, I have to let people know what's up. And then
what is up?
My voice.
Like it's a high voice. Is that what you mean?
No, I can't sing falsettos, but
let's hear one. He's telling the truth. I thought a seagull was flying outside by the window.
You should get a pet seagull or pet bees.
Ooh,
pet seagull. That? I'm gonna get you pet bees for your birthday. I'm gonna let them live in here.
What's this?
Here's a little
name?
Story. Here's a little story that I would love for you guys to hear.
No, for real. I'm gonna get you pet bees.
What's
the
seagull's name?
Hey, you know what's so funny? That could be the Christmas present that you never got me, but you got everybody else one in the house.
He didn't give me anything.
Okay, this is so apparently Kian's best friend, whatever, literally Christmas comes around in the house, he buys everybody presents but me.
I got cereal in a box.
I'd rather
you got like 37 boxes of cereal.
I know, that lasted me a good month.
You threw it away when we moved out.
I didn't get anything.
You did not.
There was like two boxes left and I brought it.
Okay, where's the big box then?
I threw it out, I think.
Okay, replay what I said. You threw it away. He said no, and then repeat.
The big box. I didn't throw away the content, which is cereal.
Anyways, I'm not done.
I bought the box too.
Didn't get a Christmas present. Anyways, I'm not done. My birthday rolls around, and let's keep in mind that he just gave like JC this big ass long ass paragraph on Instagram, saying how much he loves him, and like I get that. That's amazing.
That's my boy.
You know, on my birthday, I posted a story. I was like, hey, I'm 23. He sends back two letters. It said HB. Happy birthday.
HB.
Best friends, but all I get, he takes off to London.
He took you to London for your birthday?
Oh. I was like, hey man, my birthday's in like a week, we should do something.
Well, yeah.
Celebrate
and
your
then he's
birthday,
like,
though.
Yeah, to be a good friend, I went to not leave Harrison out, I went to celebrate your birthday with Harrison.
What? That makes no sense.
The seagull's name is Scuttle. That's a fun word. Scuttle.
No, it's
Scuttle.
Albatross.
Scuttle.
Albatross.
Scuttle Albatross the third.
Scuttle.
But anyways, he's a bad friend, that's what I'm saying.
Those hot fries make me.
Can bad friends do this?
Yes, bad friends can do that.
Yeah, I just put it back.
You know, if you can do that, you are the worst friend.
Let's see if I can do it.
Dude!
Oh, dude, that went I'm over a there. Good ass friend.
It's either that or Scuttle.
Or Albatross. Think of it.
Albatross like, isn't a word, is it?
This becomes like the end of this video.
Is
dude,
it say? Do you think?
You just
it's pushed, behind it. It's behind it.
Dude, you just pushed the gum onto my love sack. Dude, get off. Get, oh my.
Stop.
Or is it?
It's right here. You just push it off.
Oh, like fucking Bobby said.
I thought he went behind it. You just pushed it. I don't gum over my love sack. Please don't tell me you threw that.
He threw it.
No, he didn't. It's in his hand. I see it.
I don't think it is.
Ow, what's in those hot fries, dude? I'm getting a cramp.
I'll put a cramp on it.
No.
Alright, guys. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. If you actually like
that's it.
It's been like 20 something minutes and you're just throwing gum at this point and.
That was like a 5-minute podcast.
I think.
It's been 20 minutes.
Okay, for the rest of the,
burns me.
For the rest of the podcast, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. What made you start wearing your hair like that?
I changed it a while back.
Oh.
Basically, when I was on tour,
First off, that's my idea. I thought of that back in the house. I was like, Corey, it looks really good down.
I did it in the house actually once before, but then it wasn't long enough. And then I got my hair cut and I like had it back and I got out of the shower and it was like down like this and I walked out of tour. I was like, hey, should I wear my hair like this? I asked you, I asked JC. And it was like,
I wasn't there or else he would ask.
Yeah, it looks good. So I was trying it again and then there was a lot of girls that complimented me, said it looked really good.
What old boys.
And then I was like, hell yeah, this is getting me ladies. I'm keeping it.
Dang, I believe that.
Okay, you have a question for me?
Yeah, I have a question for you, Corey. Where's your favorite place to shop? Because you're becoming a fashion icon. Where's your go-to? What if people around the world want some of fashion?
Dollar stores.
I just go to Michael Kors.
I shop at Forever 21 and H&M.
Those are good. Or Gucci or
Topman.
Where the fuck's my Gucci wallet?
Gucci. You should have taken it that day.
No.
What? You got a Gucci wallet?
He got a Gucci wallet. He joined.
I found a Gucci wallet and then I gave it in for them to repolish up
because
I
found it. It's fake.
You found it?
Look at it.
He found the Gucci wallet by giving them money and they handed it to him and he found it in his hand.
It's free. All I had to do was give him money. Now that we're all going to be nice to you, what do you have to say to the old us that used to be mean and rude to you?
I only did it.
And JC likes to use the same excuse, but he hasn't known you as long as I have. But I only did it because you're like a brother to me, and that's what you do to like your siblings. You mess around, and then the next morning you're like best friends again. So it's like I would do that out of love, not out of hate. I wouldn't do that just to like hate on you just because like I hate you because I don't hate you.
Well, no, I
so
don't.
So now what do you say to the old me?
I don't necessarily care about the.
Okay, I'll do it again. Back to old Kian.
Our whole problem was. Strangers being mean. It's like if these people watching right now, like their friends.
Don't call them those people, they're viewers. They have a name.
Viewers.
There's probably Alex, Ashley.
If Ashley out there messes around with Manchester and they're like joking around and then I come up and I don't know Ashley and I'm like, Ashley, you freaking loser! And punch her. She's probably not gonna like it that much, but she's cool with that between her friends.
Well, the
so
thing,
that's the
thing,
here.
The thing that I'm stuck between.
I would never punch a girl.
The thing I'm stuck between is that in videos, like I kind of have to let you guys do it, because if I fire back to you guys, I get a lot of hate because your fans are like, why is Corey attacking Kian and why is Corey attacking JC?
He's so got a pop of one off
camera. I can't do, like, on camera, I can't really do anything towards you guys because I'll get a lot of hate. And then you guys, like, kind of treat me how, like, you treat me, and I usually I'll fire back off camera. But when you guys do it on camera, all your fans that see that and look up to you think that it's okay to do it to me too.
We have an image we have to portray online, and we have been portraying the wrong image. So, from Kian
and Bobby. Only,
yeah, from me personally, I do not want to portray that image anymore. Guys, it is not cool to be disrespectful to your friends, let alone to anyone. So please don't treat Corey with disrespect and treat other people with respect as well. What do you have to say, Bobby?
Wait, so you're saying you're not going to be mean to him ever?
I see.
I will. I will.
Just more, not on camera.
More off
no,
camera than on.
No, just whenever you deserve it. Like, if you're drunk and you're being like a little screw nut, then I'll probably be a little screw nut back it.
Actions speak louder than words.
I don't know. I'm usually pretty nice to Corey. I'd throw you some zingers back in the day, but he knows. I'm the nicest one to him out of everyone.
You're nice to me.
I went to London for his birthday. That's the biggest present.
Without me?
Well, yeah, say
no, keep going. What were you just going
to
say about me?
You're pretty nice to me, but there's been some times I've seen in videos where you guys were giving me shit and then you jump in.
That's what I said. I throw some zingers here and there.
Because, like, there was the video.
But I always.
There was a video where I got something right and then you. All you guys were, like, talking shit and then Bobby's like, yeah, you dumbass or something like that.
He did say that.
That was not a direct quote from me, as you can
tell. Yes, it was. He said, fuck you, Corey.
That's replay footage.
But
not existing. Like
it was the one where we all sat down and to answer questions.
No, I don't deny that I was a part of it. I'm not denying that. I'm saying I'm the nicest one out of them all, but that doesn't matter.
I don't really.
We're all on the wrong here.
I just
it's time to turn a new leaf.
Sure. Let's go leaf.
There's a leaf right here.
Let's go get maple leaves from Canada and come back.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for watching.
I brought you to Canada. That's how good of a friend I am. I flew him out to Canada and I flew him out to Atlanta. There you go. I'm a great friend.
Hold on.
Just remember that.
Don't. Everyone knows.
He flew me out to Canada, which is amazing to see him
eight times.
Be on set with him. Then he locked me out in the cold ass balcony for 4 hours.
Do you know what he did to me?
When it was freezing and it was less than like 32 hours. It was zero degrees Celsius.
No, I brought you out to Atlanta, but you brought me to a Blink-182 concert.
That's right.
Yeah. So we're all very good friends. We treat each other with respect. Just an occasional
breaks my window.
He's like, hey man, he wants to come to Australia, but I'll leave you in the desert for 4 hours.
Hey, I only owe you $5 now. Actually, no, I'll pay for your meal once. I already said that.
Yeah, at the Ivy.
You guys went to the Ivy without me?
No.
It's my favorite place.
I'll go to the Ivy.
We haven't.
I'm in the Ivy.
Alright everyone, subscribe to me, fanjoy.co/Bobby, brand new line out, right now.
Alright guys, if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you like these kind of podcast things, you guys actually want me to do it for real and get out the mics and stuff, let me know in the comment section down below. Go subscribe to Bobby, go subscribe to Kian and JC.
And subscribe
to Kian's channel.
To Corey,
subscribe
to my channel. 300K.
Almost at 300K,
post notifications
guys.
On.
Turn on my post notifications and I'll see you guys next week.
Tomorrow. He'll see you tomorrow. He's doing data logs.
Yeah.
Woo!
See ya.
Woo!